We're broadcasting live from Hexon, Texas, home of the Spoilers. We're at AK-47 Stadium, where the fans are required by law to carry firearms 24/7. So put your bulletproof vest on and let's go, America! Pain, suffering, humiliation, and possibly a conga line. This game's gonna have it all. The Grim Bay Attackers battle the Hexon Oilers. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. It's time to tune in, turn on, and drop what you're doing, because MFL Game Day is on the air. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. So what's the game plan for the home team today, Bricks?
I think you gotta keep it simple. A little cough syrup? Maybe smoke a little untidy pod pregame so they can keep their heads in the game. I mean, literally. You don't want to get decapitated on the opening kickoff.
I say go after the refs early and often. No mercy.
Oh, with the brutal hit! Second down in a very lot. And they stack the line and he gets his bell rung for a yard. Third down and the punter is warming up. Dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And he got it off. That's a decent punt. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
I had a dog named Snag.
And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. And it's first and 10. And the ground game is starting to soften up the defense. First down. It's first and 10.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy.
Oh, come on, that was a cheap shot. That's why I love this guy. And so do the fans. And it's first and 10.
He could go all the way.
Well, back to the bench. He dropped it, you putz.
Second down and 10. The defense better watch out. The quarterback just threw a murder ball.
I'd love the murder ball.
He could go all the way. First down. He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. First down and one. Crowd goes wild. Touchdown! Touchdown! Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. Straight through the uprights. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. First and 10. And the quarterback is down.
Zoom in on his face. I want to see if the little bastard's crying.
Second down and more than the QB would like. And that's a run for no gain. Down and, well, good luck. Oh, and that's how you play defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I do. The guy should have fucking caught it.
Nice punt. Should move him back. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score.
Boom!
And it's first and 10. And oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
First and 10. And he picks up maybe 4 on that play. Second down and 6. Oh, and he might have just saved a touchdown on that deflection. Third down and 6. You can tell he's a berserker because he's dropping at the mouth.
Airball! Hey, did we start running ghosts into the NFL rim?
No, that was just a shitty pass to absolutely no one. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. The cross-stitching, unbelievable.
They let the punt drop and it will be down by the defense. Second down and 10. Remember, folks, in the NFL, you are allowed to touch the quarterback just like that. Third down, and the punter is warming up. One in for the first down. Oh, no, that was totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they have raincoats in the front row because that was splattering everywhere.
And it's first and 10. Kills. This is really a violent game, guys. more than kickers? Well, there's your answer, Bricks.
I know, I hate those zebra men.
And it's first and goal. It's a jailbreak. And the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Oh, crowd's loving it. And it's first and 10. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It's good. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, no, Bricks. It means he can return it for... You know what? Oh, look at this guy break tackles. He broke free and has open field in front of him. Nice run for 5 yards. And it's first and 10. Second down and 7. And he was steering a pick 6 but dropped the interception.
And that's why he's on defense, schmuck.
And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. And there's another pick. Man, this quarterback must have learned a lot about sharing when he... Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. Dirty trick. The last play is a race. How did they do that?
Did they go 88 miles per hour? Just asking.
Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with no mustard? Oh, boy, they're going for it. This could get uglier than the baby resulting from an orcish fight.
And this guy just exploded into flames. Now the defense has to try to tackle a running bump. Now they keep the ball on the ground, and it paid off. First down.
When I played the game, we'd let them get a first down just to hit them 4 more plays. It was fun.
First down and 9. Ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Grim? That line ain't moving.
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Bricks. 2nd down and 9. That's the end of quarter one. Well, the good news is there's still time to make it a game.
And there's still time to get a beer.
2nd down and 9. Put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? The offense lost another running back and only 2 remain on the roster. But a team loses all their running backs, they lose their ability to run the ball.
Yeah, like if I rip out your tongue, you won't be able to speak. Tell us something we don't know, genius.
Third and two. The receiver didn't stand a chance. Man, this coach must have played too many video games. You gotta punt it here. Come on. The defense knocked the pass down, and quarterbacks hate that. And it looks like we've got a penalty here. First down and one. Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
Yeah, still work on my salami here, Bricks. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep.
And it's first and ten. QB is dinking and dunking the defense to sleep. 1 yard on that pass. Second down and nine. Oh, great play. He is on that receiver like glue.
You know, when I was little, my dad used to make me eat glue. My tongue would get stuck to the roof of my mouth, and I couldn't talk.
Your father was a very smart man, Bricks. Very smart.
And the quarterback throws another pick. He should have. Oh, that's a vicious hit. And the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. And it's first and ten. Second down and long. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and ten. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the NFL. And it's first and 10. Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Oh, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
That was probably all the diarrhea.
Well, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort. And he...
Oh, he's going berserk. The ball carrier... I don't know whose eyes the QB is using, but can we get him some new ones? Oh, the unstoppable force meets the explodable object. Oh, and the late hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time. The offense lost another quarterback on the previous play and had only two left before they have to forfeit.
Yeah, but on the bright side, Wim, they save a ton of money by not having to pay those guys anymore. The funeral expenses, that is.
And it's first and 10. The roid rage dirty trick transforms a player into a rampaging lunatic for the duration of the play. I know that's typical of all NFL players, but this is... Oh, man, Bricks, you gotta love a player who goes down fighting. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. And it's first and 10. Well, the quarterback just threw a sonic blast to his receiver, knocking down the entire defense.
My glasses just shattered.
You wear glasses?
Only when I read.
You read?
Second down and a lot. At this point, with multiple interceptions, the QB...
And whoever said never hit a man when he's down is just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
And that'll be second. Defense has enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. And it's first and 10. Second down and 10. Boom to the moon. Another loser bites the dust. In the NFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
Third down and long. Well, that is one big mutant sandwich down there. One guy's definitely toast.
That's what you call a club sandwich, Grim.
And it's first and 10. And this guy runs angry and runs hard. First down. It's first and 10. Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. Now the offense is running low on running backs. They have only two left. They need to conserve those runners now and continue. consider passing more. And it's first and 10. And he stayed with the receiver and deflected the ball. Second down and 10. Broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the oil rig?
The quarterback calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have two left. And that'll bring up third and one. Boom, dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Was you can't kill the messenger because he's gonna kill you, but then he won't be able to read the message because the messenger killed him. Ah, going in circles.
And it's first and 10. Was stuffed at the line of scrimmage.
So was that cheerleader.
And the offense goes into the hurry-up formation to try to conserve time. And the ball falls to the ground. That's incomplete.
He needs to throw it when the receiver can catch it. What's he doing?
And groundbreaking analysis as always there, Bricks.
Thank you. I do my part.
Was stuck to him like glue. They get ready for the kick. This isn't a gimme. The kick is good. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. And he just wrestles away from that tackle. And it's first and 10.
See what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
The offense has only one quarterback left. If he dies, it's game over.
This new QB, he don't even look too confident. He's pleading with the coach on the sidelines about something.
Yeah, he's telling his coach to punt. What a pussy.
Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a two-minute drill. QB know which team he's on?
I don't even know where I'm at.
Oh, man, Bricks, you gotta love a player who goes down fighting.
Oh, my God, a man from prison just came onto the field.
It's the ref, you idiot. Let's see what the penalty is. The Hexon Oilers get crushed literally and lose by forfeit today. It's probably a good thing the game ended up in forfeit. They weren't going to make it out of the stadium alive with this performance anyway. The fans were going to kill them if the opposition didn't.
Gotta love that fan passion.
Let's hear what the game's MVP has to say about this carnage.
I'd rather listen to Sarah Palin read the entire works of Shakespeare.